أستاذ أمين، أبونا مارك طلب إن إحنا نتكلم مع بعض على أسرار الكنيسة. أبونا طلب إن أنتوا في السيم بتاع النهضة المرة دي 7 أسرار و7 أعياد، فهناخد 7 أسرار الكنيسة. ابتديت أنا أول سر بيهم معاكم، هو سر الأفخارستية. The Lord said I am the bread of life. الحقيقة لما نيجي نتكلم على هذا السر العظيم، هو سر الإفخارستية، آباء الكنيسة كتبوا وقالوا حاجات خطيرة جداً عليه، لكن إحنا في القداس الغرغوري بنقول إيه؟ قدوس قدوس قدوس، وبنقول وغير موصوفة هي قوة حكمتك، وليس شيء من النطق يستطيع أن يحد لجة محبتك للبشر. غير موصوفة هي قوة حكمتك، وليس شيء من النطق، محدش يقدر يتكلم على عمق محبة ربنا لينا. Ineffable is the power of your wisdom. The power of his wisdom unmeasurable, and no manner of speech can measure the depths of your love toward mankind. أي وش إن كلنا نفكر مع بعض لمدة دقايق بسيطة ونشوف هذا الحب العظيم اللي ربنا أعطاه لنا لما قال لنا خذوا كل هذا هو جسدي. The greatest love that God granted us when he said take and eat my body. عشان نعرف خطورة وأهمية هذا السر، احنا بنيجي نقول في القداس اول ما نبتدي نقول ووضع لنا هذا السر العظيم. He instituted for us this a great mystery of godliness. هذا السر العظيم الذي للتقوى. This great mystery when we receive it he will help us to be a righteous people. The greatest mystery of godliness to be a good people and live a godly life. نيجي وأثناء القداس كده أول ما أبونا نقوم بعد ما نقول أمين أمين يقول اجعلنا مستحقين أن نتناول من أسرارك المقدسة طهارة لأنفسنا وأجسادنا وأرواحنا. Make us worthy for this great mystery for the purity of our souls, our bodies and our spirit. يبقى احنا كده بناخد حاجة تعطينا حياة أبدية، بناخد حاجة بتعطينا طهارة. يجي في الآخر أبونا يقول بعد الاسمة القدسات للقديسين، the holies for the holy. يبقى احنا بقينا دلوقتي قديسين، وبعدين في الاعتراف الأخير يعطى عنا ايه؟ خلاصا وغفرانا للخطايا وحياة أبدية لمن يتناول منه. The holy for the holy, given for us for salvation, remission of sins, eternal life to those who partake of him. I wish that we can think, what is the Eucharist, what is the Holy Communion that we receive in every time that we come to the church, and what is the importance of this. طبعا ربنا يسوع المسيح دخل أحشاء الست العذراء، خلاها بقت إيه؟ ملكة السمائيين والأرضيين، مش كده؟ When the Lord entered into the body of ten Mary, she became the queen of the heavenly and the earthly. And as we magnify her and bless her in every time we come together. When he entered the house of Zacharias and Elizabeth heard the voice of the greeting of St. Mary, she was filled with the Holy Spirit. امتلأت منين؟ من الروح القدس. لما ربنا دخل بيت زكا طلع منه راجل قديس، مش كده؟ When enter in the house of Zacchaeus, he converted him to a great saint and a great man. When enter into the house of St. Peter, what happened to his mother-in-law? فاهمين انا بقول ايه؟ لما ربنا بيحل في مكان، المكان بيحصل فيه تغيير عجيب جدا. دخل بيت يايروس وكانت بنته ميتة. When enter the house of Jairus, what happened to his daughter just was dead, he raised her. فكروا عشان هو بيدخل جوانا كده. ربنا بيدخل جوانا. دخل بيت يايروس أقام ابنته المائتة طبيسة. دخل بيت زكا حوله الراجل قديس. دخل بيت سمعان شفى حماته. كل مكان بيحل فيه ربنا بيحصل فيه ايه؟ A great change and a great miracles. And we receive him every day that we come to take communion. قال بهذا السر تحفظون من الأعداء. By this mystery we are preserved from the enemies. When the enemy come to attack us and found Jesus inside you, he cannot approach. By this mystery we are kept preserved from the enemies. تعرفين لما يجي نحفظ أكل ونحط عليه مواد حافظة فالأكل يعيش، ما فيش ميكروب يقدر يدخل جوه الأكل اللي محطوط بيه مواد حافظة ليه وينمو، عشان إحنا حفظنا هذا الأكل بالمواد الحافظة. إحنا دخل فينا السيد المسيح له المجد جوانا، واخدين بالنا؟ يعني إحنا دلوقتي بناخد جسد ودم ربنا بيحل جوانا. هل تحفظون من الأعداء؟ القديس أبو مقار قال كده، بهذا السر تحفظون من الأعداء، ومن يتهاون بهذا السر فإن قوات الظلمة تقوى عليه. من يتهاون بهذا السر فإن قوات الظلمة تقوى عليه. يقول بهذا السر نتقوى على الانتصار على كل أنواع الخطايا المحيطة بنا وعلى الشياطين وعلى الشهوات الداخلية. By this mystery we have power and strength to resist all the evil like the germs and virus around us and to help us to defeat our lustful feeling and desire inside us and help us to resist all the enemies that are around us. عشان كده يقول الكتاب المقدس كثير من الناس طلبوا ان ايه؟ ان هم ايه؟ يلمسوه. Many of the people wanted to touch him and whoever touched him he was healed. Whoever touched the Lord Jesus Christ he was healed. What about us when we eat him and take his body and his blood? معايا في الكلام ده؟ عشان كده ربنا كان حريص جدا. Our Lord Jesus Christ is very very careful not to die for us to give us life but to give himself for us as a living bread inside us. He took bread, blessed it and broke it and gave it to his disciple and said, take it, this is my body. And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to his disciple, drink from it all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant which is shed for you, for many, for the remission of sin. This is the institution of this mystery. After the Lord ascension to the heaven, نسمع عن التلاميذ يقول ايه؟ And they continued steadfastly in the apostolic doctrine and fellowship, in breaking of the bread and in prayer. Breaking of the bread, القديسين قالوا كده, when we institute this mystery, it built the church. يعني احنا بنقيم سر الإفخارستية, وسر الإفخارستية هو اللي بيقيم الكنيسة, والكنيسة حية لغاية النهاردة بهذا السر العظيم. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son that whoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. To understand what the meaning of love. I can love you, give you this cross or give you a gift or give you something, but I can love you to cut myself and to let you to eat me. How can we measure this love? You understand what I'm saying? That's why now before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come, that he should depart from this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. To the end. Not to a certain measure, but to the end. That's why he offered his himself to us. هناخد شوية آيات بسيطة كده لما ربنا اتكلم في إنجيل يوحنا على التناول. For the bread of God is he who comes down from the heaven and gave the life to the world. Then they said to him, Lord, give us this bread always. If the bread come from heaven and give life to us, to the world, give. And Jesus said, I am the bread of life. What we are going to take every day in our daily life, when we come to the church, we take the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. And to see that it's our satisfaction from the bread and the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. Next. Most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me had everlasting life. I am the bread of life. He repeated it again. And this is the bread which come down from heaven, that one may eat of it and not die. Every time we will eat from it, we will not die. I am the living bread which come down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I shall give is my flesh, which I shall give for the life of the world. So we are taking a true flesh of the body of the Lord. It is not a word, but it is something physical to eat it. Next. Then Jesus said to them, most assuredly I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. I will raise him up at the last day. What is the last day? If you remember the story of Lazarus last Sunday, when the Lord said to Martha, your brother will live, she said, yes, I know that he will live on the last day. She didn't imagine that he will give him life right away. She said, yes, I believe that he will raised on the last day. Imagine today is the last day of the world. Tomorrow morning is the eternal life. Today the Lord will come and change the world to have eternal life. This is the last day that we are all of us waiting, this last day. أما الناس تقول إمتى القيامة هتقوم وإمتى المجيء الثاني؟ وين ده القيامة جات والمجيء الثاني جه؟ يبقى النهاردة هو آخر يوم في الحياة. فon this last day, all those who ate the body and drank the blood of God, they have life in them, so they will be raised up on the last day. الحينئذ يسمع الذين في القبور صوت إيه؟ ابن الله يقوم الذين فعلوا الصالحات إلى قيامة الحياة. When they hear the voice of God, they will raise up like a person who is sleeping. When he hear the voice of his mom or dad or his friend, they will wake up. He said that we will wake up on the last day. And he said that, for my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. قال كده يثبت فيا وأنا فيه. قال طول ما الغصن ثابت جوه الشجرة بيجيب ثمرة، لكن الغصن اللي مش ثابت في الشجرة قال كده يقطع ويجف ويرمونه عشان يحترق. عشان كده he abides in me and I abide in him. هنفهم الكلام ده بعد شوية مع معلمنا القديس بولس الرسول لما قال الكلام ده. As the living Father sent me and I live because of the Father, he who feeds on me will live because of me. And this is the bread which come down from the heaven, not as your father ate the manna and are dead. He who eats this bread will live forever. The Holy Saints told us when we ate the manna, it helped us to live in the wilderness. During the time they were in the desert, they lived by this manna that came from heaven. It gave them life until they enter into the physical or the earthly Jerusalem. And by this bread and blood, we have food up to the entering the new Jerusalem, which is the kingdom of God. طبعا in Arabic بسرعة كده، قال لهم يسوع، الحق أقول لكم، ليس موسى أعطاكم الخبز من السماء، بل أبي يعطيكم الخبز الحقيقي من السماء، لأن خبز الله هو النازل من السماء الواهب حياة للعالم. فقالوا له، يا سيد أعطينا كل حين هذا الخبز. فقال لهم يسوع، أنا هو الخبز، أنا هو خبز الحياة، من يقبل إلي فلا يجوع، ومن يؤمن بي فلا يعطش أبدا. الحق أقول لكم، من يؤمن بي فله حياة أبدية. أنا هو خبز الحياة، آباءكم أكلوا المن في البرية وماتوا، هذا هو الخبز النازل من السماء لكي يأكل منه الإنسان ولا يموت. I hope that we can understand this word. أنا هو الخبز الحي الذي نزل من السماء، إن أكل أحد من هذا الخبز يحيا إلى الأبد، والخبز الذي أنا أعطي هو جسدي الذي أبذله من أجل حياة العالم. فخاصم اليهود بعضهم فقال يا مسوع الحق أقول لكم إن لم تأكلوا جسد ابن الإنسان وتشربوا دمه فليس لكم حياة فيكم. من يأكل جسدي ويشرب دمي فله حياة أبدية وأنا أقيمه في اليوم الأخير، لأن جسدي مأكل حق ودمي مشرب حق. من يأكل جسدي ويشرب دمي يثبت فيا وأنا فيه، كما أرسلني الآب الحي وأنا حي بالآب، فمن يأكلني فهو يحيى. هذا هو الخبز الذي نزل من السماء، ليس كما أكل آباكم منه وماتوا، من يأكل هذا الخبز فإنه يحيى إلى الأبد. بسرعة كده عشان نفهم الكلام ده ونشوف ربنا كرره كتير قد إيه. هو أن he gave his body this is a new covenant. There is an old covenant given to Moses and given to, by the خروف الفصح by the Passover lamb. But there is a new covenant through his blood. إحنا عارفين طبعاً if I lost my blood in accident, nothing can replace the blood except a blood. The blood gives me a life. Imagine a person had certain failure of his organ. Kidney failure or heart failure or whatever, lung failure. And he cannot breathe or cannot work because he has a failed organ. So we have to replace this failed organ by a new organ. Yes? What we call organ transplantation. لو عملتوا كده statistic بيقول كده number of men and women and children on national transplant waiting list, very great number, more than 100,000 person waiting for the transplantation. Next. 17 people die each day waiting for an organ transplantation. Every donor can save 8 lives. يعني if I right now write my will, when I die, take my organ and give it to the people need organ transplantation. A person can save a life of 8 person. يعني 2 kidney, 1 heart and 2 lung and all this stuff can be transferred to a person waiting for this organ transplantation. When a person receives an organ, he is supposed to die today or tomorrow, but when he receives the organ, his life is just extended as much as this new organ is working in him. And we can see all these statistics, and 42,000 transplanted were performed, for example, and every 10 minutes, another person is added to the list of this organ transplant. This is some statistic in the beginning. This means that if I receive a living organ, never die in my body, then I will have eternal life. And this is to show how God loves us. He said, I will die for them, not only die for them, but I will give them a living organ in their body to let them to live up to eternal life. That's why he said, who eats me shall never die and will have eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. When we die right now, we are not dead, but we are like sleeping people, have a living organ inside me, is working every day during this time until the second coming, then I will be raised again. Imagine I give you something to live forever. You cannot imagine this love. ممكن أنا أكون متضايق من واحد وأقول إمتى أخلص منه؟ إمتى يمشي؟ أو God forbid إمتى يموت؟ لكن عشان ربنا يدينا نفسه عشان نعيش نبقى زي ربنا. Nobody can live up to eternal life except God. So this great love that he offered himself to us to have a life equal to God. And we come to take the communion, unfortunately, coming late, very depressed, very sad, نعسانين, مش جاهزين للمناولة, مش متوضبين كويس. When the Lord wanted to prepare the Passover, he sent two of his disciples and he said to him, you'll see a man carrying a pitcher of water, follow him. When enter the house, talk to the master of the house and ask him where the master, the teacher can prepare the Passover, and he will show you an upper room well furnished, well prepared to prepare a the Passover. قال لهم سيريكم علية مفروشة مجهزة معدة عشان نعد الفصح. قال لهم هتمشوا تلاقي راجل ماشي شايل جرة، امشي وراه، أول ما يدخل بيت اتكلموا مع صاحب البيت قولوا له أين هو المكان الذي يعد فيه المعلم الفصح لتلاميذه، فيريكم علية مفروشة مجهزة well prepared and well furnished for to prepare the Passover. When I will come, I will receive the King of Kings. I will receive the Lord inside me. I have to prepare myself. The saint said to us, remove the sin by full repentance, faithful repentance, and furniture your body by love and humility and forgiveness, and come to be ready. Imagine I am in emergency and I find a heart from a man just died in a car accident, and I transfer this heart to a person waiting for heart transplant without doing any examination, without any preparation for the person. Then when I put a foreign organ inside me, the process of rejection will start. You understand? So I have to start to examine the patient and examine the organ, what we call in medical study tissue typing, and what the blood group of this patient. And we have to make all this preparation, examining the patient, examining the donor, examining the tissue, and if it is suitable, compatible, we can transfer it. If you transfer a blood not compatible to a person, who will die immediately. If I receive a blood group right now different from my blood group, it will kill me right away. Although I receive it for helping me to live, but it is the cause, also the same cause of my death and the same thing. So if we make this, we will say this person is guilty. Yes, and we have to judge him. And this is written in the Bible 2,000 years ago before discovering the organ transplantation. If we transfer an organ to a person without examining him, we are guilty and we have to be judged that we did something wrong. If I receive the living body of the Lord and living blood of the Lord and not ready, then the process of rejection will start. Imagine this person that after he receive an organ, what the cause of rejection? As I mentioned, incompatible, no match, and then this organ will act as a foreign body, the person will resist this organ. His immune system will increase to fight against this organ. So this person, instead to become a good person, will become weak, because the new organ is not working perfectly. Then he becomes sick, and the third step, he will الكلام ده انا قلته من كلية الطب. واخدين بالكم؟ شوفوا كده مكتوب في الإنجيل ولا لا. I mention this as we see every day in our daily life when we transfer an organ to a person and this person is not accepting this organ, and there is a process of rejection will start in the life of this next. So the Lord wants us to give a gift of life to every person of us. When I receive a new organ, I have a gift of life, but with a limited time until this organ is failing and I will end my life. So God wants to give us the gift of life. Next. Here, there is a human organ for transplant, but the Lord said, a divine organ for transplant. I am the living bread. I'm going to give you. There is a card that read it in your pocket if you sign. That this card say donor card. I would like to help someone to live after my death. The Lord said, I want to let the world to live after his death. So he write this donor card on his body. This my body is for every one of you to live after my death. And this is what they took here. You have life, pass it before you die. Pass your life after you die. And the Lord passed his life to us because he is God, can give us eternal life. These people can give me a temporary life when I receive the new organ. But God, when he gave his life to us, his body to us, he gave us an eternal life. Next. So here in the book of Corinthians chapter 11, for St. Paul said, I receive from the Lord which I also deliver to you. that the Lord Jesus on the same night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, do this in remembrance of me. And the same manner also he took the cup after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant, is my blood. Do this often as you drink of it in the remembrance of, for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. Now he said that, therefore, whoever eat this bread or drink this cup of the Lord in unworthy manner, and I make the transplantation without preparation or examining the person, will be guilty in the body of the and the blood of the Lord. So the process of rejection, رفض, أبتدي. أنا خدت حاجة مش بتاعتي الجسم أبتدي أرفضها. لو أنت دخلت في إيدك كده شوكة صغيرة تلاقي فيه صديد وألم, أول ما تشيل الشوكة تستريح. Because there is a foreign body came to your body, you have to remove it in order to be healed. So if I take this living organ in a dead body, the process of rejection will start. Then he said, let every man, let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and the drink of the cup. You have to examine yourself before coming to receive this. You have to prepare your upper room. You have to go up and prepare yourself and looking what you are going to receive. It is not a normal food or a regular bread. For he who eats and drink in unworthy manner, not compatible, not preparing himself, eat and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. When a patient go and receive a new organ without preparing himself, he did not know that we kill somebody in order to give him life, but he is not ready to receive this life, so he take it in a wrong way. For this reason, many are weak, as I mentioned. The first process of rejection, the patient feel that he is weak. His heart, his new heart or new kidney or new liver or new lung is not working. You understand? So become weak. Make the test, find all, everything is wrong. You understand what I'm saying? Then after he become weak, he will be admitted to the hospital because he is sick. And we try to stop the process of rejection, but we fail to stop it, then he will and many, he said not few, and many sleep. And this is to show the danger that we receive something to give us life in the opposite direction. It gives us many are, for if we would judge ourselves, we would not be judged. Now, when the process of rejection starts in a person, we give him what we call immunosuppressive drug. My immunity resists the new body, the new organ. المناعة بتاعتي الطبيعية ابتدت تقاوم العضو الجديد اللي دخل جوايا. فأنا بقول للعيان ده أنا هديك دواء يقلل المناعة بتاعتك عشان جسمك يقبل الدواء, لأن مناعة جسمك بترفض الدواء, بترفض العضو ده. فwe take give immunosuppressive drug to suppress the immunity of the. Sometime بنحط العيان ده في العناية المركزة ونقول محدش يقابله ونحط ماسك عليه اللي يقابله عشان ممكن أن يكون عندي عيا أنقله للعيان اللي أنا قللت المناعة بتاعته عشان يقدر جسمه يقبل العضو الجديد. لو أنا باخد الدواء باخد الدواء if I receive the body and the blood and still I have my immunity not to repent, still in my weakness, still do the same mistake that I do before I take the communion. I am not fully repented. I am not fully examining myself. I am not ready to receive this organ. Then my immunity, my lustful feeling and desire, my bad history, my best history will resist the new communion that I receive. Then the process of rejection will start in me. And this is very important to all of us. So I have to separate myself from the circumstances that make me to sin again. Because there is no company between light and darkness. I receive a light now in my body. If I live in a dark place with sins, still using my iPhone or my computer, watching bad movies, watching bad stuff, still communicating with evil people, now the new organ that I receive will start to a process of rejection. عشان كده ربنا قال لا تقاوموا الروح القدس، وقال ايه تاني؟ لا تحزنوا روح الله القدوس الذي به ختمتم، وقال ايه تاني؟ لا تطفئوا الروح القدس. He said to us three things: don't resist the Holy Spirit, don't quench the Holy Spirit, don't put a the Holy Spirit to grieve the Holy Spirit. So the process of rejection starts, then the Holy Spirit will depart in me. So the source of eternal life will depart from me. أنا مش عايز أطول عليكم. We have to understand when we receive the body and the blood, we're receiving eternal life. We're receiving a living organ inside us up to eternal life. If we are not keeping our eyes on it, where the process of rejection starts. The patient received the new organ, he is very careful, never communicate with other people, take all of the immunosuppressive drug, make every month a measure, a blood test to see how the process is going. If his immunity started to increase, they have to suppress the immunity to separate him from the people. I have to watch myself. If I'm still going to the same circumstances, the same places, the same people, and do the same sin, then I said, I take communion, but I didn't take any benefit because you didn't give a chance to the new organ to work in you, but you always resisting it, and that is why you quench the work of the Holy Spirit or grieve the Holy Spirit or resist the Holy Spirit. It is very important of us as we start the seven mysteries. The first mystery is the body and the blood of the Lord. You don't know how much love God loves us. No one can give a person something to live equal to him and the same life. You understand? So we are going to live eternal life with him in heaven. So we have to be ready for this eternal life from now in order to have a good company. But if we reject him now and resist him now and quench him or grieve him now, why he should accept us to the eternal life? You understand what I'm saying? ربنا يعطينا دايما حياة الاستعداد للتناول، لأن حياة الاستعداد أقوى بكتير جدا من إن إحنا نتناول. لما نجهز المريض كويس قبل ما ننقله الجسم الجديد اللي هياخده المرض، العملية تنجح والمريض يعيش. لكن إحنا ما جهزناش المريض كويس، العملية تبوظ والمريض يموت. إحنا طبعا كلنا مرضى لهذا الحب العظيم، وكلنا أشواق نشوفه ونعيش معاه. ربنا يعطينا حياة أبدية كل ما نتناول، له كل مجد وكرامة الآن وكل أوان وإلى الأبد. آمين.